Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Ollie and welcome to another episode of Ollie's Opinions. I know this series has been on a bit of a hiatus and it was partly down to me. You know, I'd needed a bit of time to kind of relax. And the thing with YouTube videos is when you don't really have a topic you feel comfortable talking on, it is a bit difficult to make a video, so it was really kind of waiting for a topic to emerge which I felt like I could comfortably discuss. But I am back. Hopefully these videos are going to be a lot more often. I'm not going to try and put a kind of time scale on it and say, oh, once a week or once a fortnight. I think it's going to be more a thing of, you know, when I feel like there's a topic that needs talking about, I'll make a little video. But yeah, I just wanted to give that little bit of an explanation as to why there was loads of videos coming out and then no videos. And also one other thing, there is a new task word uploaded talking about the kind of conversations Newport County fans have on Facebook, or briefly touching on chat rooms. But yeah, if you do like task word, as a lot of you do, go and watch that video, but watch this one first. So then, today we are talking about Sheffield United, and the more kind of overarching topic of it all is Chris Walters' departure. This had been rumoured for a few days. I think rumours started coming out around Thursday evening, Friday morning, but I did just want to wait until something official came out from the club before I made a video talking about Chris Wilder. And that did happen on Saturday evening. I'm filming this on the Sunday morning. So yeah, we're going to have a little look at Chris Wilder, talk about his time at Sheffield United as both a player and a manager, and then talk about, you know, where Sheffield United go and where Chris Wilder goes, and kind of just sum up the situation a bit nicely. So then, in terms of Chris Wilder pre-managerial career then, he did play at Sheffield United as a player. He was a right-back. It was his first senior team. He did spend some time at Southampton's Youth Academy, but he played for Sheffield United between 1986 and 1992. A few loan spells here and there. I think he only made just under 100 actual appearances for Sheffield United, but he did really start off his career there, and he did make a return to the club between 1998 and 1999. So he already knew the club, Sheffield lads. I think he grew up supporting them, so going to Sheffield United was probably a big thing for him as a player. And then, you know, he retires from football, I believe it was 2001. Goes around doing a few odd jobs. I think he had a stint at Northampton Town, a stint at Oxford. Joined as the manager of Sheffield United in 2016, whilst the club were in League One. That season, they went on to win League One with a record points total of 100 points, which in the first season as, not first season as a manager, but first season as the manager of the boyhood club, is a very, very impressive achievement. They then had a season in the Championship. They managed to remain there. And then in 2019, following a 1-1 draw against Leeds, they were promoted. I don't think they went up as champions. I think they went up in second. But promotion to the Premier League in 2019 did secure Chris Wilder's second promotion in three seasons, which is unreal. It's kind of Eddie Howe, Danny Cowley-esque, really. So yeah, into the Premier League. Lots of people really tipped them for relegation. There's always a team that comes up from the Championship and goes straight back down. Lots of people thought that might be Sheffield United. And I think credit to both Chris Wilder and all the players at Sheffield United. They really defied expectations. They went and finished ninth. They did look highly likely to get a Europa League place or a Champions League place. You could sit and argue that project restart, maybe put them at a disadvantage because they had so much momentum before the pause for the pandemic. But regardless, they finished ninth, the best Premier League finish for Sheffield United, I think, since 1992-93. So they played amazingly well that season. They really put themselves on the map and, as I mentioned, really defied expectations. However, this season, it's been a totally different side. I'm not going to focus too much on the run-ins of this season and, you know, what's gone wrong for them. I have partially spoke about that in the Premier League surprise package video. Talked about how they've had injuries to key players. Obviously, they lost Dean Henderson, who was on loan from Manchester United, and they've brought in Aaron Ramsdale, who might not be the best. In terms of where they are now, when Chris Wilder has left them, they are bottom of the Premier League, 14 points from 28 games. They look all but relegated. You know, there was this kind of nice narrative where they picked up, I think they picked up a win and a draw, and people were saying, oh, it could be the great escape, but the form's been too inconsistent. They've not been winning games they probably should have won. And I think they are all but relegated at this point in time. The interesting thing to note is, in the club announcement, it was that he is left by mutual consent. It's not that... I don't think he's been sacked. I think he's had a discussion with the board, and I think he's walked away. I don't think he's been sacked. A lot of the fans in the comment section of the post was suggesting that maybe there was a fallout between Wilder and the powers that may be above him. I don't know the specifics. I don't think many people know the specifics except, you know, the board, the staff of Sheffield United, and Chris Wilder. But whether he left on his own terms, whether he left because of an argument, or whether he was sacked, I do think he is probably going to be a icon in the history of Sheffield United. He was a manager for 227 games, won 106 of them, drew 47 and lost 74. To take him from, you know, being in the depths of League One to gain two promotions in 3 years, to finish his second in the Championship, to the highs of ninth in the Premier League, I don't think anyone can put into dispute his influence and how important he's been for Sheffield United. Do I think it's the right time for him to leave? No. As I've mentioned, Sheffield United look all but relegated. They're going to go to the Championship. They're going to need to rebuild. They're going to want to get back into the Premier League. Is Chris Wilder the best man for that job, in my opinion? Yes. He knows the club better than anyone else. He's been there for the last 5 years. The group of players he's got now are players that he's brought in. He said, I want these players. He's kind of made this team his own. He's going to know what's gone wrong. He's going to know what's gone right. He's going to know what changes he needs to make. So if it was a situation of the board wanted him to go, I think it's a massive mistake from the board. I think if he chose to go, I think it's still a bit of a mistake on his part, because he could have had that redemption season in the Championship, came straight back up, and they could have gave it another shot. But ultimately what's happened is Chris Wilder's left, as I've mentioned, either through his own terms or the board have pushed him. He's gone. In terms of where Chris Wilder goes now, I don't think he's going to be hard done by for management options. You know, there's talks about him going to Aberdeen in the Scottish Premier League. I think there's still a number of, I wouldn't class them as high profile jobs, but there's certainly a lot of teams in the lower half of the Premier League whose managers haven't got the greatest job stability. For example, Steve Bruce at Newcastle, lots of hands are starting to turn there. Ralph Hasenhüttl at Southampton, but I think they are going to stick with him, and rightly so. And then possibly higher league, not higher league, higher up in the league, championship side, like a Derby or somewhere like that, if a manager was to leave. In terms of who Sheffield United bring in to replace him, I think there's a large pool of options he could pick. I think the three it is going to come down to, and this is sounding bizarre, is Frank Lampard, Eddie Howe, and Rafa Benitez. Firstly, Lampard, he had that one season at Derby, took them to the playoff semi-finals. Maybe he did get a bit cocky and ended up losing it, but he's got that championship experience. He knows how it works. He knows how to manage a team within that league. He could be a very good choice. Secondly, after that, then Eddie Howe, who's very similar to Chris Wilder in the kind of narrative of his managerial career. Takes Bournemouth from League Two, brings him all the way up to the Premier League. He did leave when they got sacked. He does know how the lower leagues work. He does know how to get the best out of a kind of resourceless side. Not in the sense of, they've not got the resources in terms of players, but money is very hard to come by for Sheffield United. So Eddie Howe, again, could be a great candidate. And then Rafa Benitez. Would it be a dip down for him? Possibly. But you look at his season with Newcastle in the Championship, very similar circumstances, relegated from the Premier League, rebuilt, came back stronger, won the Championship, and then I think he led them to a fairly high finish. I think he led them to 11th or 10th in the Premier League the first season back. So Rafa Benitez, I feel, in that situation would be the ideal candidate. But Lampard or Eddie Howe can come in and do a job. What I do know is that the future now for Sheffield United, where they go from next season in the Championship, is going to be interesting at most. And it is definitely a team to, keep an eye on. But as always, that's just my opinions on the situation. If you did enjoy the video, go down, drop a like, leave a comment. Who do you think is going to replace Sheffield, replace Chris Wilder as Sheffield United manager? That's what I was trying to say. Subscribe to the channel, it does really help. Share the video around if you've got any Sheffield United supporting fans, or if you think anyone might enjoy the video, share it to them. But as always, my name's been Ollie, and up the county.
Many thanks for watching the latest content on the Amber Army channel. Please make sure you leave us a like. Make sure you subscribe for more content, both for the neutral football fan and also plenty of Newport County. Even more Newport County content can be found on the club's I Follow channel on the link above. It is just £4.49 per month to subscribe to that service. And those of you feeling extra generous can also support us on Patreon on the link at the bottom there. That would be a monthly donation of your choice. Thank you again. Make sure you've subscribed. And as always, up the county.